these recent fusion breakthrough announcements. I'd love to just hear how excited, how surprised you were to hear about these experiments being successful. And do you think within a decade or two that we might actually see fusion energy as a viable technology?
I do. And I think that the good thing about this successful experiment at the Lawrence Livermore lab in the United States is that it proves that we are on the right track. That the lines, I don't want to get too techie here, but the lines, the research lines that are being pursued are correct, that we are extracting from these experiments far more energy that we are putting inside. It's a matter of getting the necessary stability. You know, plasma physics is incredibly delicate, and it requires a lot of conditions to be reached in order to have a commercially usable means in this area. But let me say, since we are talking about this very important things, that we see a very interesting time for nuclear energy in general. Now we see that to get to a decarbonized energy mix, nuclear must be part of the solution. Nuclear is part of the solution. So be it fusion in a few years, but good old fission. Now it has a very important role to play, and the IAEA is there to ensure that it's done safely.
You just heard my guest talking about fusion, and that's a thermonuclear reaction that actually creates more energy than it requires. Unlike fission, which is currently used to power nuclear reactors and weapons, fusion would generate no dangerous waste or cause meltdowns at power plants. It's a holy grail for the future of energy and has long been a goal for scientists everywhere. Earlier this season on GZERO World, I asked U.S. Energy Secretary Jennifer Granholm about the Biden administration's ambitious goals for fusion.
The president has made a commitment. He has a vision in a decade to actually see commercial steps toward fusion. Fusion is really hard, and this is why it's been so difficult to achieve. However, our Lawrence Livermore National Laboratory, we have a national ignition facility that is focused on fusion with lasers, made a big milestone in the past few months to be able to achieve that.
And achieve that they did. In mid-December, at that very lab, scientists successfully carried out a short burst of nuclear fusion. It only lasted a few trillionths of a second, so I'll be honest, I missed it. But it was enough to count as one of the biggest scientific breakthroughs of the past century. It's a victory for the United States in an ongoing race against China to develop the first commercial fusion plant. Don't get too excited. By all accounts, it could take decades before fusion can happen at scale, but still, what a difference a few trillionths of a second can make.